Hello everyone, and we're back. We're back again in Train Sim, and we're back again to look at a new line, and this time we're going to look at the Birmingham Cross City line. Now this line has recently come out for Train Sim World, so I thought, why don't I do it in Train Sim Classic? So I don't have Train Sim World, and I'll probably get around to playing it one day, but at the moment I just have Train Sim Classic. I'm quite content doing that. So I just thought, let's just do the first mission. It is very long, it's 84 minutes. I probably won't do all of it in one go. But it's an early start for your first service along the Cross City line. Starting at Birmingham New Street, you'll then take a train, that number there, ECS, which stands for empty coaching stock, so it's an empty train basically to Bromsgrove, and then you'll operate that train, that code there, and all stops to Four Oaks. The lines are quiet at this time of the morning, but you still have time. So it's a foggy autumn morning, 5:45. Let's start the scenario. So the last video I did was the quite amusing video where if you enjoyed that, then make sure you give the video a like. If you haven't yet watched it, then give it a watch. It should be the last video I did on my channel. Let me know which train you want me to take next up the Lichfield incline. There's loads of possibilities. Also, a new mountain route come out for Train Sim. It'd be interesting to take a pacer up as well. Good morning, driver. It's an early start to make sure the first morning trains depart on schedule, otherwise the whole timetable easily gets into a shambles. Take this empty coaching stock down to Bromsgrove non-stop and then operate back to Four Oaks as train U03, stopping at all stations. Get the train ready and depart when a starter signal allows you to. So we'll get the train set up. I've not driven one of these before, so this will be quite interesting to do. So it's very dark in here, it's master key, it's reversing. Probably need to put it into neutral first. Tail, I don't want tail, it's one marker lights. To the back of the train and pop the tail lights on. There we go, got the tail lights on. Let's cycle back. This is a very long train, as we can see, especially for this time of the morning. It looks like we just see Birmingham New Street. It looks like an underground station, but it's not really, it's just undercover. So it looks like we just have 323s here, no other type of rolling stock, which is a shame. I would have liked to have seen a different kind of rolling stock, but anyway, it's night time in Birmingham, so yeah, let's think we're not opening the doors, we're just going to go. So, because this is empty, hazard lights. Okay. They're bright, aren't they? That must be if the train's broken down or something. Right, so let's go into forward. Am I moving? I'm not moving, so there's something I've not done. Or DRA, there we go. This is the weirdest sounding train I've heard. It makes very strange noises. It's also the fastest accelerating train as well. Very, very fast acceleration when you put it into notch 4. It's a very slow speed limit departing from Birmingham New Street, 10 miles an hour. So it looks like it's an underground station, but it's not really, it's just under a very large canopy. That's what the horn sounds like. What's that beeping noise? Pressing Q. What do I need to do? Floor pedal. So I have to press the floor pedal to get. That's weird. It's pressing Q, but it wasn't doing anything, so. View, yeah, we do. So it's 3x2 seating, which doesn't use a very narrow gangway. I suppose it's built to cram as many seats in as possible, as many people in as possible. When we next stop, we'll have a more detailed look at the train. Keep it on power one for now. So it looks like picking up passengers from Bromsgrove, we're due there at 6 minutes past 6, and we're due to depart at 11 minutes past 6, so we'll have a bit of a wait in Bromsgrove, and then we're stopping at all those places until we stop at Birmingham New Street at 6:40. And then we go to 4X, so it's quite a long run. Not bad interior. Speeding, so really sharp brakes on this, so probably won't be using going any higher than step one on these. Here we are, quite long. Let's see how long we are. Six cars. Not that long, but it just looks very long. Let's go to power three. Sounds okay. Probably not as good as the train sim mode 3 sounds though. On power one, it's accelerating. I watched the stream on this, the Train Sim Worlds stream, and the driver on that said that power one is a shunt notch and won't produce any power above like 12 miles an hour, but even at 50 on, it must be different on Train Sim Classic, because even at 50 miles an hour, I put it into power one and we're still accelerating. I have to turn it all the way off, otherwise we would be speeding. Yeah, it's nicely modelled. I'm not the biggest fan of electrics, but it's not bad. There's a little guard seat there, and we have a little list of destinations. I'm hoping to do a long journey in Train Sim Classic sometime. There is someone on YouTube who does these really long journeys on Train Sim Classic. He drove a Pacer all the way from Edinburgh to London, and then he drove a Voyager all the way from Edinburgh to London, and then he did a Pacer again, this time from Penzance to London. He's done all sorts of long journeys, and I'm hoping to do a similar long journey, probably in a Pacer as well. Whizzing through all these stations. So a little bit of watch it whiz through the station. So yeah, I'm hoping to do a long route in a Pacer, perhaps from Paignton to London or London to Birmingham. That's not been done. That would be a pretty nice route to do in a Pacer. Oh, it doesn't have to be a Pacer. I'd like to do, I'd like to get the 153 from Just Trains. That's the DMU of a single car. Or the 122 bubble car, which is also a single car. That's the flashing double yellow. I'm not sure what that means. I think it's just telling us to slow down for the speed restrictions coming up. Station there. Stop braking. This is like a metro style train, so the acceleration and braking is pretty rapid. Interior is quite basic. I think there's toilets on here, but not much else. Just seats and toilets, really. But that's all you need, really. It's they're not designed for long journeys, just short journeys in and out of Birmingham, really. Ferrying people around Birmingham. But a single yellow, so. Next one might be red. We've got greens pointing that way, which means we're going on to a different track. And there's a beeping. Pressing Q, but nothing's happening. Oh, now it's put the emergency brakes on. It's a foot pedal I need to press. I wonder what key it is. Is it for the foot pedal? That's what I mean about those brakes. Really, really rapid. So I have to remember that. I'll have to look at what the keyboard shortcut is. I'm sure there will be a keyboard shortcut, but I think that's to simulate the driver. So when I press it, it's going up, so the driver has to keep that pressed all the time, and then when it beeps, he's got to lift his foot off and put it back on again. So I think that's what that is. So I put it into notch 4 and you can see that acceleration. It's not causing the G meter to go down though, so. This mustn't be rapid enough to cause discomfort to the passengers, but yeah. 70 now, so we'll see what this thing can do. This has a maximum speed of 90. Let's see if I can put my cab light on, because it's a bit dark in here. It's a doll's buzzer. That sounds like a really weak buzzer. Saloon lights off, so we can turn the saloon lights off, so now it's really dark in there. Ooh. Just caught it in time. Let's put those saloon lights on, and we'll see they're back on again. Where's the cab light? We've got a 20 there, so we really need to be bringing our speed down. It's nice and bright inside the cab. Oh, we've got another AWS. Probably am going to be late on this, as it's my first one. Got a fan which I think you can turn on. I know you can in the train sim world version, but I'm not sure if you can in this. Although fan switch, you can switch it on. Got a cab heat as well. It's not a red. Slow down for that 20. Screen demister. So if your screen's fogged up, you can press that. We've got a GSMR radio, which I don't think is operational. No, that's not simulated. What else have we got here? Door buttons, which are operational. Stars buzzer again. These are all the safety systems, which you can't change. You can pull the windows down as well. We can hear the train a bit more. It does sound something like out of Star Wars, does this train? It's pretty interior view, you can't really hear the weird noises, but all the beans. Sounds nice when it's powering up, is this train. So our max speed is 90, speed limit's 90, let's see how long it takes to get up to 90 miles an hour. We also got a blind as well, which covers the whole windscreen so you can't see anything. We've got a buzzer code here, train sim, you'll only ever get two buzzers, which is ready to start. There's all sorts of other buzzer codes as well. Pass com along, what's that? Oh, pedal. There we go, I remembered. Sand in as well, so if you're getting way slow, you can turn your sander on. DRA, so that's like a reminder thing. If you're at a red signal, put the DRA on, and you won't, in case you forget that there's a red signal there, you won't be able to set off while the DRA is on. You can put your pantograph down as well, which means I probably won't get any power. Not in this car anyway, the rear car might still have power though. But seeing that pantograph is down, so let's put that back up because we are gradually losing power. Let's put the pantograph up. We should see that go back up. Yellow. Have we actually got power? No, we don't. I forgot to put that monitor back on. Trying to get that up now. Upon arrival at Bromsgrove, release the passenger doors, change cabs, and update the destination screen. Departure is scheduled at 6:11, which is only 4 minutes from now. Our ETA is 6:10, so we won't have very long at all. Got the big red button there, which is for the emergency brake. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of electrics. I prefer old diesels, like the Pace and the Class 37, but it's alright, it makes a change, I suppose. I am going to take a Pacer on this line as well. We're actually going down the Lichfield incline now. I took the Pacer up the Lichfield incline and it actually made it, although very slowly, only at 33 miles an hour, but it did make it up there. But it would be interesting to take, like a Class 37 with a load of wagons, or maybe a steam train with a load of carriages. I'm going to have some fun taking down, taking different loads up there. So see our brakes going down, you've got to be careful because our brakes are much less sharp because of the gradient, so got to be much more careful with the braking. Our AWS is going off like crazy. It seems like on this route, instead of like the triangular boards, which remove the speed reductions, you get yellow signals instead. So nearly at Bromsgrove now. So just keep it in brake one now. So yeah, I probably will do a drive for the Pacer on this route. It would be fun to take this train on the main line as well, so I might do that at some point as well. So we are a six car. pass, I think we'll have to go right to the end of the platform to fit all the carriages in. There's the 6 car marker there. Perfect stop, wow. So while we're stopped here, we'll just have a quick look around the train. So you can do a map of the network there. All sorts of safety signs. Got like penalty fare notices and lots and lots, very detailed. There's the driver's cab there, of course, all the stickers on as well. Yeah, a lot of detail gone into this. So yeah, you've got a very narrow walkway, so that enables you to get three by two seats rather than two by two seats. We've lost 1,000 points already due to timeliness. So yeah, we are running late, but there's the end. Another carriage. I think these trains have toilets, but they did on the Train Sim World version, but this version doesn't seem to have them. You've just got like a door at the end of each carriage, which I presume passengers can open. It says private there. That says, so I presume passengers can go through, but there doesn't appear to be any toilets in the Train Sim Classic version. Just very basic facilities. Basic seats, a very narrow gangway. Right, let's change ends. So, I think this will be a good time to end part one of this video because we have been gone on quite a long time. So, I think I'll end part one of the video here. Let's just have a quick look at Bromsgrove. So, you've got an overpass there. I think we'll end the video here, and then in part two we will have a look, we will drive all the way back to Birmingham New Street and Selyhook, which is where we're finishing. So hope you enjoyed this part one of this first look, and I'll see you for part two.